Thank you very much. Thank you very much, and good morning, Chicagoland.
Can they get those agents?
Great to be here with your fine governor, Jim Thompson, and your congressman, Jack Davis. And thank you all for being here. And a special hello to the great kids in the Andrew High School band. You've done yourselves proud. Now will you all do and all make America proud and just say no to drugs?
Oh, come on.
And let me say a special thanks to all of you who braved this terrible weather to be here today. With spirit and dedication like this, George Bush and I are lucky to have you on our side. We're headed into the last lap of this election campaign, and I've come to Illinois to carry the flag for the next president of the United States, my friend George Bush. He's the guy to lead us forward toward our national destiny, because he knows what you believe in, what America believes in, and he believes in too. Now, I have an announcement. We just received the unemployment numbers for October, and it's the kind of news that makes this job worthwhile. The unemployment rate has fallen to 5.2%, which means it's the best it's been in more than 14 years. I'm here to tell you, if you like news like that and you want more, you'll make George Bush the next president of the United States. As in the last 8 years, we've set our sights once again on our enduring values and our hopes for the future, and you've seen the results. They say they're on your side, those other fellows, but that's just an empty promise. They promise, but you know, we deliver. Yes, the last 8 years have been good years, but I've got a hunch that when George Bush gets in the saddle, as someone said in an old movie, you ain't seen nothing yet. He knows that prosperity has a purpose. Prosperity gives all America the opportunity to raise a healthy family in the right way, to reach out to those who need help in our communities, to dream and to make all our dreams come true. And he knows that freedom, glorious freedom, works. Yes, we Americans hold history in our hands, but only if we vote. Earlier this year, I had the privilege of doing something I had never thought an American president would be able to do. I spoke to students in the Soviet Union, in Moscow, about the glory and wonder of human freedom. Think of those students. Only if they're very lucky and rise high in the Communist Party will any one of them ever have the influence on the course of their country's history and world history that each of you can have just by going into the voting booth. Let me, before I go, ask you something. Those of you who are eligible to vote this year, I'm asking for a commitment now, and if you say yes, I'll take it as a promise. On Tuesday, will you show up at the polls and vote? And will you make sure to turn out our voters to punch 36? Will you make sure to cast your vote for family and against drugs by choosing Jack Davis for Congress? And will all of you who believe in a strong defense, traditional values, and peace and prosperity, make sure to cast your vote for George Bush for President of the United States? You just made my day. I know I have have to move on now to where I'm going to speak, but I want to thank you all, and God bless you all.
Hey, buddy.
Because he knew we meant business, and we still mean business. In fact, what they planned for the Navy is so bad that by the time they get through, Michael may have to row the boat ashore. They opposed the liberation of Grenada. They opposed the blow we struck against terrorist Libya. Now, George Bush and I did all these things, and I'll tell you proudly right now, we both do every single one of them over again. USA! down through this year at which I pledge allegiance to the flag of
Everybody in Illinois is going to know just this once how you voted.